the middle of the Cold War, the United States played a role in the overthrow of a democratically elected Iranian government. So even as we meet here today, America supports now the restoration of the democratically elected president of Honduras, even though he is strongly opposed to American policies. We do
this issue. President Zelaya remains the democratically elected president. For the sake of the Honduran people, democratic and constitutional order must be restored. And we will continue to work with others, especially the Organization of American States, to achieve a negotiated and peaceful solution.
In the middle of the Cold War, the United States played a role in the overthrow of a democratically elected Iranian government.
But, you know, after last year's election here, we were inspired by the citizens of Senegal demanding that their votes be respected and that President Sall be sworn in as the democratically elected leader of this nation.
And the U.S. government's attitude has been we would deal with a democratically elected government.
A democratically elected government struggling to provide security, armed groups in some places, extremists ruling parts of a fractured land. And so these critics argue that any
to see a peaceful transition from one democratically elected government to another was a enormous milestone for Pakistan and a testimony to the Pakistani people's desire for democracy.
After an agreement was brokered for constitutional reform, the former president then abandoned his office and Parliament endorsed new elections. So that today Ukrainians have a new democratically elected president. And I look forward to welcoming President Putin.